Hi, I'm Herbert Siguenza, and I play the role of Quijano Quixote in Quixote Nuevo.
And I'm Lisa Portes, and I am the director of Quixote Nuevo by the amazing Octavio Solis.
Yes.
Herbert, we've done this now. This is our third time around
yes.
on this one. Why do you keep saying yes?
I love it. I mean, it's our classic. You know, it really is. Don Quixote was written 500 years ago, but it's a classic.
Yeah.
It's universal. And it resonates. I think Octavio's interpretation, his adaptation to the Mexican border, to the Texan border,
yeah.
resonates like never before, as you know.
Yeah.
And so I just think it's an important piece. It's a political piece, but it's also a classic piece, a universal piece, and that's why I say yes to it.
I love that you keep saying yes to it because it makes my life so much easier. because really, I can't imagine another Quixote.
Oh, thank
and,
you.
You know, Octavio has always been obsessed, as you know, with Don Quixote, with the story, and he mm-hmm. did that OSF adaptation.
I saw that.
Which I didn't see. And I know that afterwards he was really thinking a lot about how to bring Don Quixote, the Spanish classic, to the Americas,
mm-hmm.
And as you say, to the Texan border. And also, you know, that you know it became very personal to him with his own father and the journey he was taking with his own family in relationship to... You know, and what some people would refer to as dementia, it's a clinical diagnosis. But I think in the world of Cervantes and in the world of Solis, and in your mind mm-hmm. as the actor playing it, it also just might be another plane of existence.
Yeah, and I relate to this play too because society right now feels insane to me. It feels crazy. It feels like it's not really happening.
Yeah.
And so I think that the Quixote imagining a better world is something that I imagine. But you look around and it's not happening. So I really relate to that.
That's so beautiful. I think of that moment when, you know, after the terrified boy and his father come in and his father's beating the kid and, you know, that's a rough world out
mm-hmm.
there. You know, I mean, our fictional La Plancha is a rough world. And you get hit in the head and you come back saying, what happened to honor?
Mm-hmm.
No, what is it? What happened to?
Fairness and reparation.
What happened to fairness and reparation?
Yes.
Where is honor?
And
I think that question is actually a real question for the United States right now.
Yes, where is our honor?
Where is honor?
Our collective honor, you're right.
You know,
you're so right.
I mean, in the kind of, you know, in the ways in which we're fighting with one another and
mm-hmm.
the pettiness with which our politicians are fighting, with the kind of cynicism
mm-hmm.
For kind of winning power rather than actually helping people. This question of where is honor, I think, is such an important one.
And I love this metaphor of the wall
yeah.
instead of windmills, you know.
Yeah.
Quixote wants to break down the walls that keep us from each other.
Yeah.
In his case, his Dulcinea was over the wall, over the border. And I think that's, I don't want to give away the story, but that's what it's about.
No, and I think that question of like the border, you know, I mean, when Octavio wrote this, it was, what, 2016, 2017?
Mm-hmm.
We were in both a very different and also not that different political
right.
moment in relationship to the Mexican-American border, which is
right.
the largest land crossing in this hemisphere, if
yes.
I understand correctly, the one right down below San Diego.
I also said yes to this because this is a Chicano play.
Yeah.
We're here in the regional theaters and the mainstream theaters, but it's unquestionably a Chicano play. And it has all the elements of a good Chicano play, which just has its rascuachismo, you know, the funkiness.
Yeah.
It has music, it has politics, it has bigger than life characters. So it's just
puppets.
Right, puppets. So
yeah.
it's just right up in my wheelhouse, you know, and that's why I say yes to it all the time.
Yeah, it's like a love letter to Chicanismo.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, you know, in terms of the fact that it's in a theater and how, you know, going back to this question of what is honor, I do believe that in theater, when we sit together as a community, and that community is the actors, it's everybody backstage, and it's the audience all sharing in the same
mm-hmm.
space and breathing the same air, that the questions that we ask in that room, it's like the same questions that we ask in church, you know what I mean? Like,
mm-hmm.
or in the synagogue, or in a mosque, you know, which is where is honor? You know, what does it mean to be good?
Yes,
you
yes,
know,
yes, yes.
And it crosses political lines when we share that kind of space. You know, what do we, and this play forwards some ideas about it, which is that to be good means to recognize one's sins. And I don't mean that in a Catholic sense. I mean recognize where
mm-hmm.
one has failed.
Mm-hmm.
To be good is to fight for, as you say, what do you say? I fight for the...
Fight for the unemployed, the uninsured.
Yeah!
The undocumented.
The uninsured and the unemployed. Do you know, like, that to be good is to fight for those that can't fight for themselves.
Right, and that's happening so blatantly in this country. You know, the people who have power, and the lower class is getting lower as we speak, you know what I'm saying? So it's pretty scary times.
Yeah.
And that's what this play addresses.